Welcome back to Homepage. It's a hot topic around the water cooler these days. Concerns about hackers, viruses, crashed systems. So how can you protect yourself, and what do you do when something has really gone wrong with your computer? Well, Bill Margerson of CBL Data Recovery is back with us again with some advice. Bill, great to see you as always.
Great to see you, Dave.
And you've got a little device right here in front of us, and tell us what it is and what's wrong.
Well, what I thought I'd do today is to discuss what would happen if your computer crashed. You saw a black screen, a blue screen, or some screen, or no screen.
Or no screen at all.
What are you going to do? Well, there's a lot you can do with your emergency disk from your software supplier that will help you get back up and running. But when there's new noises, then it's a real problem. Then you're going to need some serious help. Okay. What I thought I'd do today is to show you what goes on inside a disk drive when these noises are being made.
Okay. So this is a disk drive.
This is, contemporary disk drive. And when it's a power is applied, it normally runs very quietly inside your PC. Mm-hmm. And there are times, however, that because of the technology it fails, you might hear a sound like this, that tick, tick, tick.
That's also not a good sound.
That's not a good sign. On the internet, it's known as the click of death. Show you what's really going on inside this disk drive.
Ooh. I've never seen one operate, so... But it's not supposed to be doing that.
It's not supposed to be clicking. What you're seeing here are the platters and the read-write head assembly that's actually reading the bits, the ones and zeros, off the medium, and that's normally what is working. In this case, if you look very carefully, you'll see evidence of head crash. The click-click or click of death is a real problem. Mm-hmm. It's actually the disk drive trying repeatedly to really read itself again.
Okay.
So it's interesting. If it's clicking, there's nothing you can do with software. Your emergency disk can't help you. It's a physical problem. Time to power down and send it to experts.
Okay. Those experts, including yourselves, cbltech.ca. If you hear something like that, it's a matter of just turn it off. Like, don't bother continuing on.
Exactly.
Okay. Good piece of advice. You've got more horror stories. Every time you come on the show, it's always delightful to have a horror story about crashed systems. Maybe you could tell us just a little bit about, for those who are listening to us for the first time, of what CBL does.
Well, we recover data from crashed systems for people all around the world. Our motto this year, IT happens, and it does to the best of them.
IT happens, okay.
We're currently working on our second casino job. About a month ago or so, we helped an online gambling casino get back in business. Their system had been commandeered by some Russian hackers and held for ransom.
Wow.
And by golly, we've got a second case exactly the same.
So this is ongoing right now?
Ongoing right now.
So what's happened then? Someone has gotten into the online casino.
Correct. And what they've done, they've encrypted their servers, and they're currently holding these guys for ransom. And the first time this happened, a ransom was paid, and lo and behold, they couldn't get the data back either. So in this particular circumstance, they've elected not to pay the ransom, and they're flying the equipment to our lab as we speak.
Now, without giving away the trade secrets, what's the first step? What do you do to try to recover that data?
First thing we're going to do is a forensic quality cloning. We're going to mirror every single drive to one of our known good disk drives and then only work on that copy, so we're never going to adulterate the original. That's a very important step. And then we're actually going to take inventory of what's gone wrong and find out what we've got to work with. At our company, at CBL, our cup is always half full. There's always something we can do.
Yeah. Well, I mean, over the years, it's just been a handful of cases that you've not been able to resolve, so you've got the track record there. Bill, we always like to get a bit of a tip from you in terms of what home users can do. Most of us are not in the running online gambling casino, but bad guys can hack into your computer and probably are trying to hack into your computer, so maybe a tip of the month at this point would be appropriate.
Of course, we always talk back up. But I think a tip for the home user would be to make sure you have a firewall on your machine. Your personal machine needs personal protection. And there's a lot of assorted software firewalls that are available online for free. But you must have a firewall on your personal machine.
Here's your website, CBL.
tech.ca.
CBLtech.ca. That's it. Many offices right around the world. You have some right here in just north of Toronto.
Yes, we're in Markham here. We have 11 labs in 9 countries around the world. So there's always a lab close to you to help out. But we're up in Markham here. So if anyone has trouble, have them send us the drive. We'll get the data.
I know you saved our computer on one occasion when everybody, including the manufacturer, the software maker, they all said there's nothing we can do, and you guys had it fixed in 40 minutes. So if it crashes that bad, who do you call? Bill, thanks very much. We'll see you next month.
Thank you, Dave.
Take care. We've been talking with Bill Margeson of CBL Data Recovery. Well, now another edition of Tech Toys. The idea of artificial sight, it used to be something right out of Star Trek, The Next Generation. But as I found out, at the University of Southern California, they are working hard to bring science fiction to real life.